everyone, welcome to WhatsApp Soho session. Hi Amod.
Hi Anaga.
Welcome to session.
Thank you.
Those tips which you have given in last sessions, they are really helpful.
Okay.
But to extend that topic little ahead, can you give us some real life case studies?
Correct.
How those tips or points have implemented in their businesses and how they have helped them?
Absolutely. In fact, the last 2.5 months since the lockdowns began, I've met so many people on online, and a lot of customers, friends, associates, and I can give a lot of examples.
Okay.
But I have picked up two cases from each side, long term and short term, to highlight in this snippet. Okay, so the first case is of a classroom training business.
Okay.
A senior educator.
Okay.
The old school, old traditional style. So he was very, very adamant about classroom trainings. Yeah, because he came from the old style and he felt that connecting with the students in person was the only way forward to teaching them. And therefore, for the last 2-3 years, we have been trying to get to them, trying to educate them on why e-training is important, but somehow they are not convinced.
Okay.
But with this lockdown, suddenly it dawned on them that this is the way forward. But the best part of it was they really understood what it means, and then they have now really invested time, money, effort into creating long-term systems.
Okay.
So they've gotten into learning management systems, enabling technology for webinars to webinars, virtual meetings, right? Classrooms.
Okay.
So they have created this kind of an ecosystem which is not going to be beneficial just in the short term or in the lockdown period, but way beyond that. Okay, so this transition is important, and this was forced, but they really saw the opportunity in that,
right.
And then they have now planned for the growth there.
Okay.
This is one case. Another very interesting case was of a Ola cab driver.
Okay.
Okay. Now he had this single Ola. Okay. He was the only one. He was the owner of the cab, and he had debts. He had taken it on loan. So you have to pay them, and with this lockdown, everything got this thing. But that's exactly where the entrepreneurship comes out of people, right, in these situations.
Right.
What he did very smartly was, okay, he called up 10 of his other guys who were also hit by this lockdown.
Okay.
All of them had lost business. And then what he did very smartly was he contacted the government associations, the hospitals, the FMCG companies who were authorized to operate in the lockdown period.
Okay.
Right? So he got the specific permissions, he tied up, he created contracts with them to ply their goods, supplies, their emergency deliveries,
right.
Patients,
right.
As needed. Okay. And these 10 cars were then attached with various organizations. He smartly made use of that opportunity.
Okay.
So much so that very soon he started getting inquiries for more cars.
Okay.
For more deliveries, from more companies. Companies started calling him for more and more cars for their deliveries, emergency deliveries. And this is exactly what now he is planning, is to increase it to 100 cars and so on. And this again is not going to be a short-term opportunity, it's going to be long-term.
Long-term opportunity, right? Excellent.
Yeah, it is going to move in the long-term. So these two are examples where people have really made the opportunity and thought long-term about it. Okay? It may have been a short-term measure, but they saw the long-term opportunity about it. And then he is now building on the vision of growing it, scaling it further, and getting more people on board and growing the company.
Interesting.
Very interesting. On the short term, also there have been a couple of very interesting cases.
Okay.
For example, one of these friends in Jalgaon, he had this, he had just launched a very plush restaurant.
Okay.
In Jan.
Okay.
Okay. And there's a and in the first business itself it did very good business. But then at the end of February, early March itself, when the lockdowns came in, everything stopped and the business was absolutely in losses. Yeah, because no footfall. But then again, that's where the entrepreneurship comes in, and in people, right? And what I did was very, very smartly, he converted that hotel overnight.
Okay.
Overnight into a Kirana store.
Excellent.
Yeah, into a Kirana store where he really got all the permissions to get in the groceries and flourishing business. So we just happened to talk to him and we asked him that, okay, this is fine, you made it into a grocery store. Now what are you planning? Are you going to keep this? He said, yeah, as long as this lockdown situation is there, he will run the Kirana store. But his long-term vision is still the hotel.
Okay,
so he will wait for the things to open up and
open up.
He
right.
will look at ideas to create the hotel's ecosystems as the lockdowns go down and the post-COVID scenario unfolds. But that's brilliant, isn't it? In the short term, he's made use of whatever resources, whatever he had, and then he's really been growing business in, even in these times.
Interesting.
And the second one is again a very interesting one. She's one of our students, and she was about to start a small eatery.
Okay.
In Pune.
Okay.
And again, she was about to start in March, and then the lockdown thing came in, right? And business lost, right? The opportunity lost for a while. But did she take it that way? No. I mean, the kind of spirit that this girl has shown is amazing. Huh? And she goes on and starts an online training course, right?
Welcome to WhatsApp Soho Tech Byte. And today's Tech Byte is about moving WhatsApp Messenger to WhatsApp Business. This is for the users who are already using WhatsApp Messenger for their daily business communication. Just a note of caution, that you can use WhatsApp Business and WhatsApp Messenger simultaneously, provided they are linked to two different phone numbers. It is not possible to use both the apps to a single phone number at the same time. So let's see how to go about moving from WhatsApp Messenger to WhatsApp Business. So first is the installation of WhatsApp Business app. So you go to Google Play Store, search for WhatsApp Business, click on install. Once the installation is completed, you can open the app and it will take you to the WhatsApp Business screen. So click on the agree and continue button. Then you'll see a screen where it will ask you for two options. The first is use your existing number that is linked to your WhatsApp Messenger. And the second option is you can use a different number. So if you choose to use the existing WhatsApp Messenger number, so click on that option. Then it will pop up a message saying, allow WhatsApp Business to access the photos, videos, and files on your device. This means that whatever your previous chats and media is stored in WhatsApp Messenger are to be moved to the WhatsApp Business. So the previous chat will get restored with your WhatsApp Business account. So click on allow. Then it will take you to the transfer process. Make sure during the transfer that your WhatsApp Business app is on and it is connected to internet to complete this transfer successfully. In case you want to verify or connect with the new number to WhatsApp Business, so you can enter that number. You will receive a verification code of 6 digit, which you need to enter over there and get it verified. So once the verification is done, it will take you to the next step, that is creating your business profile. So this was regarding moving from WhatsApp Messenger to WhatsApp Business. Please make a note that moving information from WhatsApp Business to WhatsApp Messenger back isn't support currently at this moment. So if you choose to move back to the WhatsApp, regular WhatsApp Messenger, so you may lose the chat and media that you have been using with WhatsApp Business app. If you have any queries related to this video, write to us in comments, or you can email us at business@zoomyourtraffic.com. For upcoming videos, please do subscribe our YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video.
What do you think? Please give us your comments and suggestions. If you have any queries about our TechnoByte, do write us. And stay tuned, stay safe.
Bye-bye.
Bye.